Hello everyone! Are you interested in cultures? Are you interested in the American culture and the Italian culture? Yes! This is the right video for you because today we're gonna talk about 6 American habits you've never thought about. I just spent 3 months in America with my American husband and I'm an observer, so I observed. Let's start with habit number 1. Parking right in front of your destination. Right there. I'm from Rome, so I'm used to parking really far. And I consider myself lucky if I find a parking spot within the first 10 minutes. In America, of course, it's different because they have these huge parking lots in front of shops and malls. There was one thing that happened this summer, and I have to talk about my father-in-law. He's amazing. I just want to tell this story because it's funny. We wanted to go to a shop. Dick's. Let's say this is a big parking lot and Dick's was here and there was a convenience store right here. We said, okay, let's stop at the convenience store first. So he parked right in front of the convenience store. We got our drinks and then when we went out, I started walking towards the other shop, right? Because it was literally like the same parking lot. It was so close. So I started walking and Jim was like, wait, let's hop in the car. And I'm like, let's walk. I guess in America, a lot of people are just used to parking right in front of their destination because they can, so why not? But my Italian mind was like, well, it's more gas is expensive, less physical exercise, I guess I can walk. Love you, Jim. No hard feelings. I think we ended up walking. New American habit number 2. People come directly to your front door because there is no gate. There is no gate in front of the house. Imagine like you have the street, you have the yard, usually very beautiful and green and perfect, and then there's the house. So if the plumber needs to come, then the plumber will ring at your front door. I guess it's normal, but I'm used to having a door video intercom, so people need to buzz that first. I can look at them through a camera. They're far from me. If I want to, I can allow them into my yard. And then they have to buzz a second time. I mean, usually by that point, I'm already at the door. But if I wanted to, you know, there's like one more step. But when they ring at your doorbell, you know that there's just a thin wooden door between you and who knows. That's a little scary to me. The good thing about this is that when you walk in an American neighborhood, it looks really nice because, I mean, fences and gates are not really nice looking. American habit number 3. In America, it's really, really, really common when you're on your phone with your family and friends, when you say goodbye, to say, love you, bye. Instead of saying goodbye or just like bye, it's almost automatic that you would say, love you, bye. I don't know. In Italian, I'm not always saying our equivalent to love you, like ti voglio bene, ciao, or ti amo, ciao. Like, I do not say that all the time. And when I say it, even though it's in English, I give it the Italian importance. So every time I have to say goodbye and I'm on the phone or I'm leaving the house or any time I say goodbye, it's always like, love you, bye. It's so weird to me. I don't know why. I have to adapt to the American mentality and be like, love you, bye, love you, bye. It's more natural. Next, the 4th habit. I don't know if this is a habit, this is the law. They don't have to wear a helmet on a motorbike, which is really weird. Every time I see a biker, no helmet, I'm like, oh my God, just wear the helmet. That could save your life. That really could save your life. In America, you don't have to wear your helmet. I hope that this will change soon. Next habit. When you enter a shop in Italy, the shop assistant will say, hi, good morning, good evening. That's it. In America, they always ask, hi, how are you doing? Hi, how are you? Hi, how's it going? How, like, I was so confused because instead of saying just hi, they were asking me, how are you doing? And I'm like, Do you really care? Do you really want me to tell you if I'm having a good day, a bad day, and why? You know, like one thing is saying hello. It makes me feel like, you know, it's just polite to say hello, to greet someone. But how are you doing is the next step. Do you want to get to know me better? And at first, I didn't realize that everybody did it. I remember once I was at the grocery store and a guy was like, "Hi, how are you doing?" And I was like, "Hi, good." He must have thought that I was weird. Now I know that it's just, you know, you just have to say, "Good, how are you?" Sometimes they don't even reply. Sometimes they don't even answer. It's not a real question. Next, this is my sixth and last habit for today. I've realized that in America, no beard is still more professional, more elegant. In a lot of business situations, like even if you look at politicians, in Italy, it's fine to have a beard, pretty much. You can have a beard in very formal business situations, corporate, it doesn't matter. Like, you can have a beard. And I know that things are changing in America as well, but I think clean shaven men, they still look more professional or perceived as being more professional. I don't really like beards. I don't. I know it's weird. A lot of women love it, but it's prickly and ew. I like the American clean shaven trend. Guys, did you enjoy this video? If you did, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and subscribe to my Instagram, because I'm trying to grow my Instagram. I want to interact with you more, and I can do that better on Instagram. I can ask a lot of questions, it's fun. So, subscribe. I'll see you next time.